Hello folks, this is 2021 May June paper 1-3 and the question number is 14. This question is concerned with the chapter of forces, and it is specially with it involves a rotational motion here. It says that a book of weight W has a rectangular shape and is of uniform thickness. The book is held in a vertical plane so that longer sides of the book are vertical. So actually we're doing here is we are observing this thing from the sides. So this one is the long side, this is the shorter side. So the long side is along the vertical, this is horizontal. So this thing holds the book in this position. So we have to find which expression gives the approximate torque exerted by the hand on the book. So what happens here is actually the work of this hand is to prevent the book from rotating like this. Its work is to prevent the book from rotating like this. So what is doing is, it is exerting torque like this. It is exerting torque like this, somewhat like this, in clockwise. So the fingers are exerting torques like this. So now what we need to do is, first we have to find the amount of torque exerted by this book in the anticlockwise direction, anticlockwise sense. So for that, we have to find the force. The force is equal to its weight. So this is the weight acting exactly along the center. So this is the weight. And let me say the fulcrum is somewhere here. So it's when we have this thumb over here, the fulcrum will be slightly behind the thumb because it has to raise like this. So behind the thumb. So let us say the fulcrum is somewhere within this thumb actually. So what happens is, if I do draw the line like this and like this, this distance will be equal to A by 2. So this is A is the breadth, is A by 2. So now the torque exerted by the book in anti-clockwise sense is, anti-clockwise is equal to force equal to the weight into the perpendicular distance from the fulcrum to the line of action of the force. This is the line of action of the force. So it's equal to A by 2. So this is the torque exerted by the book in anticlockwise sense. Now to prevent it, the thumb and the whole hand, the combination of thumb and the index finger, it has to exert a force in such a way that the torque produced by the hand, by the finger or the hand, is in clockwise direction, and it is equal and opposite to this. It is equal and opposite to this. So that means what we have to do is, the magnitude of force is WA by 2, and it should be clockwise. Magnitude of torque is WA by 2, and should be clockwise. So we have clockwise. So these two disqualify. Then WA by 2. So this qualifies, and this thing disqualifies. So choice A should be the correct choice.